Notion just released a new update to button automation that may seem like a minor adjustment, but it will have a huge impact on people's efficiency while using their platform. Now you can use button automation to automatically create particular types of database templates. This will be a great thing to use if you follow different types of processes or like to present data in a different way based on the type of template in your databases. To show you how this works, I'm going to make an update to my CRM template to make creating new records a lot more efficient. I've already made a couple updates here that I want to show you before we dive into actually building it. So here on the left-hand side, I have opportunities which represent sale deals within my CRM. And I have two different types of opportunities that I work. I have new business opportunities, which represent the first time I'm ever closing a deal with a company. And then repeat is for when a company has bought my products or services multiple times. On the right-hand side, I went ahead and created a new template for both of these. And what I've done for both of them is if you go in and select edit, I've automatically changed their type. So for new business, the type is automatically new. And then for repeat, the type is automatically repeat. So let's create both of these real quick so I can show you exactly what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna select this button, gonna hit continue, then let's back out. And then let's also create that repeat opportunity. Then if you look over here on the right-hand side, you can see that those types have automatically been adjusted based on that template. Now, updating fields on a record is just one of the things that we can do here with this button automation. You can also make sure that the contents within a record can follow a certain pattern based on the database template. So to show you how to set this up yourself, let's go ahead and create a new account database template. I'm going to head to the account database, and then I'm going to come here to the right hand side, hit the drop down, and I really like some of the things that I have in my default database template. So instead of just creating a new template and starting over from scratch, I'm going to hit this, and then I'm going to duplicate that database template, and then we're going to name it new prospect account. For relationship, I'm going to enter prospect, and then let's add some information down here below that is specific to prospect's accounts and what me or other sales reps should be doing in the CRM for it. So a good way to do that is let's go ahead and just create a to-do list for this example. So I'm gonna create a to-do list, and then I'm gonna give it a heading as well, name it prospect to-do list. Then let's write down a few things. So whenever I have a new prospect account, probably want to go ahead and evaluate their website to understand their offering. Also probably wanna look at their employee account on LinkedIn. And then finally, let's say we wanna start outreach. Then here on the left-hand side, let's go ahead and create that automation. So I'm going to search for button. Then I'm going to give it an icon. I'm going to name it new prospect account. I like to personally add a confirmation. So I'm going to say, are you sure you want to create a new prospect account? And then we're going to add another step, and we're going to select add page two, and we're going to go find that account's database. And then this is the new update that wasn't previously there, where you can select the type of template. So we're going to choose new prospect account, and then we're going to add another step, and we're just going to open that new page that we just created. So new page added, we're gonna open it up into the center peak, and then that's it. We're gonna hit done. Let's move it up into the call out. And then I'm gonna go ahead and test out this automation. So let's click the button, hit continue. You can see that we have that new prospect account. The relationship was already prospect. And then if you come down here, it has that prospect to-do list. And as you can see here on the right-hand side, it starts off with that naming convention of new prospect account. So that's it for this walkthrough of Notion's update to button automation. I think using button automation to automatically create templates for your databases can only be helpful in this situation, but it also could be helpful for when your teams have different types of tasks that you're working on. And really the way that this new update can be used are endless. If you want to be up to date on Notion's new features just like this, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.